Such an honor to have you with us this morning on something that doesn't happen very often, Christmas on a Sunday. But it's good. It's good. I know that many folks came last night to our Christmas Eve service, and we had a wonderful time, candle lighting service. But this morning, we just want to encourage you and to hope that you have the opportunity as a body of Christ and as a family to worship together. You know, there's a lot of going on. There's a lot going on in family, right? How many of you have family in your house this week, and you know that there's a lot happening when family gets there? There's a lot going on in family. We're not just a group of people who want to come on Sundays and forget about each other the rest of the week, but we believe that we are a family. It's one of our pillars. It's one of the most important things we believe around here. And so in that, we have so many opportunities for people to get involved throughout the week. When you came in today, I know you got a bulletin. There's a lot happening. We just want to invite you and encourage you just to get involved. Don't be just someone who comes on Sunday, but really press in, because you know what? When we're on this journey together, it's so much easier when you're walking with somebody. Amen? I know that my wife has a group of people that she goes out and she runs with. And they go together, and I think it's just because they want to talk, and it's like their social time, but it makes it a lot easier to go out. I don't run myself, as you can tell. But she goes out with a group of friends, and it makes it easier, and they motivate each other, and they keep going. It's the same on our journey with Christ. You need people around you who are there to support you, to push you, to help you out along the way. And so I want you to encourage you to find your group. Find a people who you can run with. Whether you're here visiting this morning or whether this is your home, find a group of people who you can run with. If you are here visiting with us today, we want to say thank you. I know a lot of you are here for Christmas. We would love for you just to get, we would love to give you just a little gift. It tells about who we are, what we're about. If you're a part of this body, you know that this is very important to us. But if you are here for the first time, if you could just slip your hand up, we have something for free for you. It's Christmas. We want to give you a gift. So raise your hand, because gifts are good. Amen. Right up here up front, we got three, a couple over here. Lacey's, it's good to see you guys. We love you guys. All right. If you didn't put your hand up and you didn't get a free gift, that's not my fault. That's yours. I tried to give you something on Christmas. But I encourage you to read your bulletin if you need some extra gifts. We got our bookstore open today, and we got a lot of things happening. Our church offices will be closed tomorrow, so don't come looking for us, because you will not find us. Amen. I just want to encourage you this morning. I know that you, even on this Christmas day, you came prepared to give. We thank you so much for all that you've done throughout the year, and it's coming to the end of the year, and we're looking back on a year that we've done so much more outreach than we've ever done. We've done ministries everywhere, and we haven't had to borrow, beg, or steal for any of it. And so, amen. That's a good word. We shouldn't be borrowing, begging, or stealing as a church or as any. Never mind. You came prepared to give today. Thank you. Thank you. If you do, just an FYI, all your contributions need to be in before Friday in order to get giving credit for the 2016 giving year. So you're welcome to drop by the office anytime Tuesday to Friday, and any extra giving you'd like to do. But I want to bless you as you give this morning. Father God, we thank you for your provision in our lives. Thank you this morning, God, that we had gifts under the tree. Father, that even when it doesn't feel like it's enough, Father, it's your provision is always enough. God, you give graciously to your children. And Father, you know, we don't preach a prosperity message here, but we do put ourselves in line with your blessings, with you. We put our faith in you, and that puts us in line with your blessing, Father. And so, God, in all that we give today, let it be worship unto you. Give us wisdom in this body, in the leadership, to use these gifts as best we can to further your kingdom throughout this city, our nation, and to the ends of the earth. We love you and praise you. In your precious name I pray. Bring the buckets. Amen. Amen. This morning, I just want to give you a very encouraging short, just an encouraging word. Family, presence, service. Three encouraging words. Amen. God bless you as you go. I'm just kidding. John chapter 8, there was a woman brought to Jesus who was caught in the act of sin. There was no questioning whether she had sin. There was sin. It happened. And these men brought this woman to Jesus thinking, okay, we can get him with this. We'll get him this time. We'll mess with him. We'll have reason now to stone him, to do whatever we need to do. Jesus looked at the men who brought the woman and said, let ye without sin throw the first stone, and continue to write in the sand. I'd really like to know what he wrote, because one by one, those men left. When Jesus had raised himself up and saw no one but the woman, he said to her, woman, where are those accusers of yours? Has no one condemned you? She said, no one, Lord. Jesus said to her, neither do I condemn you. Go and sin no more. And Jesus turned to his disciples, and that was just a little background of this story and the context of it. Jesus turned to his disciples, and he said to them, guys, I am the light of the world. He who follows me shall not walk in darkness, but have the light of life. I preached a part of this message last night at our Christmas Eve service, but I want to just encourage you with this today. When Jesus came into this world, I think it's important to know what he called himself. You know, we have an idea of what Jesus is. You know, he's our friend. He's our Savior. He's our Lord. He's all of these things. And yes, he is. But what is one thing that Jesus said that he was? He says, I am the light of the world. He who believes in me shall not walk in darkness. And oftentimes I think we hear statements like this and we just hear them and we move on. We're like, yeah, we know Jesus is the light of the world. There's songs about it. This is the light of mine. We all know he's the light. He's the light. But how does that apply in our lives? The Bible says in this very verse, he said it, I am the light. And he who believes in me has the opportunity to step into that same strength and power that I possess and not walk in darkness ever again. Is there ever times when you feel like you're walking and you can't see the path? There are times when you're walking and it feels like your world's caving in around you, and circumstances and whatever else is all over you. Some of you had a rough year. Some of you, this year has been the best year of your life. Circumstances don't change the promise. Say that again. Circumstances will never change the promise. Because Jesus said, I am. He said, I am the light of the world. He who follows me shall not walk in darkness. They will not walk in darkness. Some of you may say, well, I follow Jesus and this year has been dark. When I think about this, I think about perspective. Yes, I know that one of the promises of the Bible is in this life you will have trouble. One of my favorite, I think it's my absolute favorite verse. In this life you will have trouble. That's a promise of God. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. That's not an exciting promise, but it's a promise nonetheless. In this life you have trouble, but this is a really good one. Be of good cheer, for I have overcome the world. The question is not if you will have trouble. The question is, will you choose to walk in the darkness, or will you choose to let your light shine no matter what the circumstance? See, it's just a matter of perspective. Yes, hard things happen in life. Yes, sometimes, especially during this Christmas season, there's people who can struggle with depression or with fear or with anxiety, with all these different things, but it's all a matter of perspective, because if we understand that Jesus came as the light and called us to believe in him so that we may not walk in darkness, but we carry a great light, then everything changes. Because one thing I know is that there is no darkness on this earth that can overcome light. There is no darkness on this earth that can overcome light. You hear it all the time. I've said this many times before, but we hear it all the time that just the world is getting to be a darker and darker place. But listen, I don't see that as a commentary on how strong or how great darkness is. I see that as a commentary on how great a light needs to rise up. It's not a commentary on the darkness as if it's getting darker. It's a commentary of how is that light shining. And I believe that we as a church are called to shine greatly and brightly like a city on a hill, like a beacon of hope everywhere we go and in everything we do, that we shine and we reflect the love of Jesus Christ to everyone we encounter. When we do that, darkness cannot and will not have a chance against us. This is a promise from Jesus. He who follows me shall not walk in darkness, but have the light of life. You believe in Jesus. You believe in the Christmas story. You believe that he lived a perfect life. You believe that he died for your sins, that he rose again on the third day, overcoming sin and death, and that he now is seated at the right hand of the Father. If you believe this, then you have to believe that you carry a great light. And not only believe it, but understanding that what you believe dictates the choices that you make. Your choices have to reflect that belief that you carry a great light. You have to believe and walk as though you are the answer to prayer. You have to walk as though the person that you're about to encounter, the person you're about to see, whether it's a cashier, whether it's the person at the gas station, needs what you have, because it's the absolute truth that you carry a light in the midst of darkness. Will you choose to shine? Will you choose to shine, especially in this season? Will you find someone who needs love, who needs kindness, who needs peace, who needs the grace of the Father? Would you just be that to them? You are called to be a light, as Jesus was the light. I challenge you today, as you leave this place, as you're with friends and family in this Christmas season, as you're looking on Facebook at all of the wonderful pictures, I encourage you to find who's not there. Send them a message. Say, hey, I know that this is a hard time for you. Let's grab some coffee this week. Or, hey, I know that you're struggling. Just know that we're praying for you, that you're part of us. Hey, if you need a place to go, we got lots of ham at my house. I encourage you. Find someone that's working during this season and just say, hey, thank you for being here. Hey, thank you for serving well. Some of you, you're estranged from family. Send a text. Make a phone call. Show up at a front door. Because you are a light. And you carry hope. Can I pray for you today? Father God, I thank you for every single person in this place. God, I thank you that even in the lady that was caught in the midst of sin, Father, that you didn't condemn her. Father, you launched her into her destiny. That even through the greatest struggle and circumstances that she had come to in life, thinking that she was at the brink of death, Father, you said, no, I'm going to give you hope in a future. Father, that you said that I am the light of the world, and that those who follow you shall not walk in darkness, but how the ladder of life. God, Father, for those who are walking in a place of circumstance and struggle that's not that's holding us back from the fullness of what you called us to, Father, I pray for new eyes to see the perspective of your heart. Father, I pray that you would allow us to see you walking with us in this season. Father, we love you so much. I thank you for this body of believers. I thank you for this day, for your Son, and for the empowering of the Holy Spirit that leads us and guides us daily. Now for these, God, I bless them. Would you keep them? Let your grace shine upon them and give them peace. In your Son's precious and holy name I pray. Amen. Merry Christmas. Enjoy family today. We love you. We will see you next week.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Everywhere you go, take a look in the 5 and 10, glistening once again with candy canes and silver lanes aglow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Toys in every store, but the prettiest sight to see is a holly that will be on your own front.